Hallelujah. Greetings, precious people of God. Thank you for joining me in this precious moment. Our Lord Jesus Christ has given me an opportunity to come and speak to you at this hour. I want to speak briefly about the power in the kingdom of God, or the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is the authoritative rule of Jehovah God the Father in the hearts of men through Jesus Christ and through the Holy Spirit. We have the Trinity. The Trinity simply represents God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. They work for one another, and they all work in the same kingdom. That's why I spoke earlier in one of my broadcasts that you need to have fellowship with God the Father, fellowship with the Holy Spirit, and fellowship with Jesus Christ, His only begotten Son. People of God, we have people in the world that have relationship with Jesus Christ, but they don't want any relationship with the Holy Spirit. What is the end replication or implication of this? If you just have Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and you don't have fellowship with the Holy Spirit, viewer, you will be missing something. Because the Holy Spirit comes to give us power. Actually, He is the one that is closer to us more than even God the Father or even Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us that Jesus is seated on the right hand of God the Father in the throne in heaven. But the Holy Spirit was given to us. Jesus said, I am going, but I will not leave you as orphans. I will send a comforter. He will be there together with you. He will guide you and He will teach you all forms of truth. In simple, Jesus Christ was saying, while I was here on earth, I taught you some lessons, but they were not complete because I had no much time with you. But I'm going to send the Spirit of God. He is going to teach you more about the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is full of power. If you read Luke chapter number 9, from verse number 1, then He called His 12 disciples together. These are the apostles. An apostle, it simply means to be called and sent. You are called and you have received that message to go and take it to people for the sake of the kingdom. To be sent, simply to be chosen and to be sent. And He gave them power and authority over all devils and to cure all diseases. And He sent them to preach the kingdom of God and heal the sick. The moment Jesus Christ has called you in the kingdom, He gives you power. He gives you authority. And then He gives you anointing. What is the purpose of having authority and power from the kingdom of heaven? It is to kick out all devils or to cast out all devils and demons that bring suffering in the life of people. And to cure all manner of diseases, whether virus, whether bacteria, whether fungus, whether sicknesses that affect the blood, the skin, the bones, and every part of human body. Even the skin, the diseases that affect the heart. There is authority and power in the kingdom to kick them out. People of God, the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter number 28, verse number 18, Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, "All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. Lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." This is the Great Commission. And it is only available in the kingdom of heaven. Jesus said in verse number 18, authority and power in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. And therefore, I'm commissioning you. I'm sending you to go and do discipleship. Have followers in the kingdom. Brethren, one of the main reasons why we are having this broadcast is to campaign for the kingdom of heaven, is to emphasize on the need of being a follower, a disciple of Jesus Christ, is to emphasize on the need of having salvation in Christ Jesus. Fewer. The Bible says in the book of Mark, chapter number 16, verse number 17 to 18, them that will believe, these signs will accompany them. They will be able to cure the sick, to cast out devils, and to destroy kingdom of darkness. 1 John 3:8, he who commits sin is of the devil, because the devil sinned from the beginning. And for this reason, the Son of Man was made manifest to destroy the works of darkness. The kingdom of heaven came purposely to silence and to destroy the works of darkness that fight humanity. Hallelujah. The kingdom of God came to make ordinary people to do extraordinary things in Christ Jesus. If you read Luke chapter number 10, verse number 18, I'm talking about the kingdom of heaven. When after Jesus had sent the 72 disciples to go and preach, when they returned, and the 70 returned again with joy, saying, "Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name." And he said unto them, "I behold, I saw Satan falling from heaven like lightning from the heavenly places." Remember, the Satan sometimes abounds in heavenly places in order to block the blessings of humanity. But the Bible says the moment they went and preached the kingdom, Satan dropped down like lightning from where he was holding the blessings of the people of God. Today I am making a prayer through this broadcast. Every demon, every work of darkness that is holding you captive, that is hijacking your spiritual realm and blocking your blessings, let it catch fire and be destroyed by the power of Jesus Christ in the kingdom of heaven in Jesus' name. People of God, I want to pray with you before I end the broadcast. Maybe you are watching this broadcast and you are not born again, and you like to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me all my sins. I am a sinner. I would like to receive you. Change my life and change my story. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for viewer. Let them receive your salvation. Let them receive your power in Jesus' name. Maybe you are sick in your body and you like to receive healing. I want to pray for your healing now in Jesus' name. Wherever you are, just stretch your heart towards the screen as I release this anointing to heal you. Be healed right now. Every form of sickness, disease, affliction, and bondage in your body, I command it to come out in Jesus' mighty name. You are free. Begin to check your body. You can even go to the doctor and request for a test of the sickness that you are suffering from. You are healed, you are delivered. For one-on-one deliverance prayers, viewers, you can visit us here in Kenya. You can call the number on the screen, or you can even request for a Zoom healing service, and we will pray for you as the Holy Spirit shall guide us. God bless you, viewer. May the Lord do you good. In Jesus' name, amen, amen.